It's Morphin time. Zero range of one. Pink.
Could you talk us of you? Where were you born? Where did you grow? What was your beginning of actress?
I was born in Australia, in Sydney, Australia, and I was there. I've actually been in America now longer than I was in Australia. I was born in about an hour and a half out of Sydney, and I went to a performing arts high school, and that's kind of where I discovered my love of acting and dance and singing. And when I left high school, I ended up modeling and getting into acting very early, and I was 20 when I came over for Power Rangers. They brought me over.
What did you think of Power Rangers before to integrate the TV show?
I actually didn't know a lot about it. I watched an episode before I came on the show, so I kind of had some idea what it was before I started working. It didn't make a whole lot of sense to me, to be honest. So that was probably a good thing because I wasn't as intimidated.
You passed the casting of a movie in 1985 to get the character of Dulcea. What could you tell us of this casting?
So yes, I went out for that role. I was a little too young for the role. The girl that played it, Gabrielle Fitzpatrick, was, I think, perfect for that part. But it was kind of a premonition for what was to come, I guess. I'm very grateful that I got to be the Pink Ranger instead. It was actually worked out better for me.
How was the casting to integrate the TV show? How were you to get the character?
So I got an audition from my agent, just like a regular audition, and I didn't actually know that it was to be a Power Ranger at that point. It was just another TV show, and I had to do a scene, and then I had came back for the callback. I had to do a martial arts routine, and then the third callback was with the producer, Shuki Levy, and then I met with him, and I remember saying to him when I left, I hope you make the right decision, which was very bold. And about 2 or 3 weeks later, he called me personally to tell me I got the part.
When you passed the casting for a character of Cat, did you know this was to become the new Pink Ranger, or you think this was just a simple secondary character?
I didn't know it was a Power Ranger. I didn't really understand what I was replacing someone. So, yes, I thought it was a secondary character until I was cast, and then I realized that I was going to be... Yeah. I knew I was going to be a series regular, so I knew I was going to be on the show, but I wasn't sure of the capacity of that.
You replaced Amy Jo Johnson in the TV show. How was the passing with her?
She was. We didn't work a whole lot together, but it was a little uncomfortable. You know, she was choosing to leave, and this new person was coming into her family, so it was a little uncomfortable for both of us. But she was very nice, and I think they did a good job of making our characters very different.
Patricia Jolly replaced you in the season 2 bow. How was your passing with her?
She and I worked very well together. She's very sweet person. But again, it was awkward because someone new coming in and I'm leaving, so it's uncomfortable. There is an uncomfortable feelings between, not towards her, but just in general. It was just, it's hard. It's hard to say goodbye.
There is a lot of references down in Australia with your character of Cat. Was this your wanted of you?
They had filmed the first movie in Australia, so the producers really loved Australia and wanted to bring that international character into the show. So they really worked, they asked me a lot of things about Australia and how I would say things, or they wanted a lot of my personal opinion actually to do with the character.
Okay.
So. I liked that. I think it brought something different into the show.
And you met Haim Saban in the studio. What did you think of him?
Haim's a brilliant man. He's a brilliant businessman. He's very... he was very nice. He was very polite, but he's very much a businessman.
Jason David Frank taken back his character of Johnny Oliver in this season, Dino Thunder. Would have liked you to appear also?
Yeah, I've always open to doing a cameo or something like that. I think that would be fun for the fans to see where Kat is now. Maybe coming back as a mentor or something like that. I don't know that I would necessarily want to come back as a Power Ranger, but coming back as a mentor or a mother or a big sister or something to the future Rangers would be fun.
In your opinion, what will become the character of Kat after Les the Power Rangers? Because in the special episode of Christmas on season 0, we discover Kat is married with Tommy, and she's granny. Is that your vision of evolution of the character?
Yeah, that was a funny episode. I think that Kat would have gone on to do something as a humanitarian, something to take care of the world. She was very much about taking care of the environment and taking care of people. So maybe she did something, missionary work or a Peace Corps or something. And I think her and Tommy probably would have gotten married. I could see that.